December 28, 1958 was the day that the modern NFL started. The Baltimore Colts beat the New York Giants in overtime in the NFL championship game at Yankee Stadium when Johnny Unitas drove his team downfield in overtime, and the game ended when Alan Ameche took a handoff and plowed into the end zone. The game caught the attention of the American public. It also entranced a Dallas money man named Lamar Hunt, who kept failing in his attempt to buy the Chicago Cardinals so he can move that franchise to Dallas, or getting an NFL expansion franchise for Dallas. After watching the game, Hunt decided if he could not join the NFL, he would form a rival circuit, the American Football League. The 1958 championship game was dubbed the greatest game ever played. That is open to debate, but this much is clear: football and television were a perfect match. Television would fuel the NFL and football's rise to the top spot as America's favorite sport by 1965. The NFL would radically change, pushed in part by the American Football League's 1960 start and the AFL's use of TV revenue sharing, where all the teams would split TV monies equally. The NFL wanted to follow the AFL's lead, TV revenue splitting, but it couldn't, as it violated antitrust laws. On September 30, 1961, President John F. Kennedy took care of the problem by signing the Sports Broadcast Act of 1961, and that spurred the NFL's incredible growth during the 1960s. The NFL and AFL would merge on June 8, 1966, but that would require congressional approval and President Lyndon Johnson's signature. That happened in October 1966, and by November 1st, New Orleans got a team, and America would get a Super Bowl. The 1950s NFL ownership group never had a business plan, but got lucky with the televised 1958 championship game. It launched a new business. I'm Evan Weiner for the Politics of Sports Business.